one to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. Oh, yes, and with your admission that you'd feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Believe me, I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart.
I don't want to set the world on fire, honey. I love you too much. I just want to start a great big flame down in your heart. You see, way down deep inside of me, darling, I have only one desire. That one desire is you. I know, baby. Ain't nobody else gonna do
it. I've lost all that for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you'd feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Believe me, I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart.
Condenses into cylinders, and the cylinders, if they came up against water, they'd blow the end off. So we've got the cylinder cocks open, that's what you can hear hissing up there to let it all out. He's on the side, right, carry on, chap. You're all right. We use water and boiler pressure to overcome boiler pressure.
Yeah.
If you want to go away and read your physics, you'll find out how it works.
These tubes are the main drafting requirement to heat the water, and these tubes contain the superheaters which reheat the water after it's been past the regulator.
Right.
So it gets two goes. Superheat means that it's heated again. So the steam is heated twice in one of these superheated boilers.
We induce velocity in the water, basically, don't we? By condensing.
And a series of cones.
Yeah. Don't get Mr. Bullock on with that.
No.
He knows it's pilot pressure, but I don't even know how it works.
As a piece of engineering, this is almost irreplaceable, and this is the most irreplaceable part of the steam engine, really, the copper firebox.
Right,
just like your train.
So you're like sort of teasing her, feathering it. Do they all have a different feel? Is there like a different knack to them all?
Even two of the same type are different.
Yeah?
This has got a big water capacity on there because where it worked on the southern region down to the other side of London, there was no ability to pick water up from the troughs. Most railways had troughs where you picked it up between the tracks while you were going along. The Southern Railway, because of the third rail, didn't, so they had big water capacity in their tenders.
I'll do this side anyway. I know the actual boxes are all right. Yeah, I'll just do this side. I'll just do this side. You can do the other side as well. There's nothing coming. Just some wagons I want shifting one platform. Well, I used to do the edge. A lot of bits to oil, isn't it? <laughs> If I ordered it up, it's a big job actually. The driver's booked for an hour just to oil that, actually. I mean, the fireman's booked for 2 hours to prepare the fire after it's been laid and lit by the cleaners and the early shift fitter who supervises it. And then the driver gets an hour literally to go around the whole engine, outside, underneath.
What you've got in there is what they call an underkeep.
That should do it.
And in that underkeep there's a pad, an oiling pad, which sits in a bed of oil. But underneath it's sheep's wool and everything. I will show you one. And it sucks capillary. It sucks the oil up onto the shaft.
Then of course we have to fill this up as well. So. And it's all total loss. So all the oil you put on just ends up by getting sprayed all over the loco. So these locos always look extremely grubby. More to do because of the fact that it's the, all the oil that gets splashed all over it.
Yellow signal.
is to get the engine ready so it can stand overnight without any fire in it, without any steam in it, basically. That's the next thing. Putting it away now. That'll be another hour.
I just put the blower on a bit more just to take that smoke away for you. These are the gauge glasses. These tell you how much water you've got in the boiler, and you need to make sure that you've got that tube in the middle with the actual water in it, and then you've got this thick glass surrounding it, and that's in case that glass bursts. And if it bursts, it contains all the steam and hot water that would otherwise go shooting out. So it's as well to have the gauge glasses clean. But they all fit in a slightly different way. Good from the fireman's point of view, if you give them a wipe out. You could spend a long time as a cleaner. Promotion could be very slow, and you would certainly spend many, many, many years as a fireman. And it's a bit of a pyramid system, really, because you needed comparatively few. You know, when you talk about driving locomotives, people always think about the guys driving the crack expresses. And none of the old railway companies needed very many crack express drivers. So the entire system was designed around people dropping out. You know, and some people never got any further than being a fireman. There were plenty of guys who, even though they became drivers, never got any further than driving coal trains or, you know, goods trains, which was a lot less demanding because you move more slowly, and so there was less chance of things going wrong. When you leave here out on the main line, you climb all the way up to Goathland, and just after Goathland there's the summit of the line, and you start going downhill. So of course when you go downhill, the water in the boiler all surges to the front, and that matters because you've got to keep the firebox top covered, otherwise it melts. Kaboom. No engine, no nothing. So you've got to get the water in the glasses right up to the top. So you're constantly managing not just the fire, but the amount of water that's in the boiler, as well as making sure there's enough pressure in the boiler so the driver's got steam to do the job that the engine needs to do. So it's a complicated job. There's a lot to think about. It's a nice craft job, because you can't learn it overnight. That's one of the nice things about it. You only get good at it by doing it over a period of time. So it's a skill that you build on very gradually. And it can be, you know, as you make each little bit of progress, it can be really satisfying knowing that here's something else that you understand, or here's something else that you can do. So next time you go out, you'll do it a bit better.
Well, I'm sure Adrian and someone took some pictures, didn't they? I'm sure someone took some pictures. I don't think I did, but I'm sure someone did. But it wasn't that wide. There was a visible line, but it hadn't opened up.
I don't exactly know where it is at the moment. We'll have to try and find it. It'll probably be buried down the siding at the back of the station, down the bottom of the station somewhere.
Do you know where Repton is?
Hello.
Good morning. Are you well? You've got two spanners on your shoulders, so it must be happening.
Yeah.
Go on.
Repton apparently has got a problem with lubricator. What's it doing? I've just noticed it's going down back in siding.
It's gone two. Down to siding two.
Yeah.
It will swap with the incoming weekly.
Right.
It will swap with the incoming down grade.
So Repton's got a Whitley, is it?
I turned it up and it started to feed like, and that's by the way, it makes this water, that's filling out. Anyway, then it started to blow.
Alright, but you know when the front restrictor's blocked, because the oil's got nowhere to go. And it just back feeds up and you get oil halfway through the glass. Yeah. And that's when you know that it's not getting through. Yeah. Marvellous.
You're the second person this morning.
It's going to be well noisy.
Slightly early, so you've got to go back again till you get the buzzer.
We've cut this little hole in the frame so we can see it. This is which will obviously do that back up again.